السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. On behalf of Markaz Sahaba, the voice of Ahlus Sunnah wal Jama'ah, we present to you lesson number 1419 of our daily Nasiha and advice. Today, with the grace and mercy of Almighty Allah Jalla wa Ala, we focus on Duba'a radiallahu anha. Duba'a, Dhod, Be, Alif, Ba, Alif, Ain, and a Ta in the end. Her full nasab and lineage is Duba'a, the bint of Zubair, the daughter of Zubair, and Zubair was the son of Abdul Muttalib al-Hashimiyya, which means that she is the daughter of Mustafa Habibuna sallallahu alayhi wasallam's uncle Zubair bin Abdul Muttalib, and her husband was Miqdad bin Aswad radiallahu an, a very, very senior Sahabi. So Duba'a is the wife, Miqdad bin Aswad is the husband, and she gave birth to Abdullah and Karima. So these are the two children, one son and one daughter. And her mother, that is Duba'a bint Zubair's mother, is Atika bint Abi Wahab. So we come to know who's the father, we come to know who's the mother, and the husband and children, and how she is related to Mustafa Habibuna sallallahu alayhi wasallam. We find a hadith which is mentioned in Abu Dawood, Nasai, Tirmidhi, and various compilations. She, Duba'a radiallahu anha, came, atatin Nabiya sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, faqalat inni uridu al-hajj. I want to go for hajj, and I made intention for hajj, afa ashtaritu, but she was a bit sickly and so forth, and she wasn't sure whether she will manage the entire journey, going to Makkah Mukarrama, and then there in Makkah, then Mina, Arafat, Muzdalifah, so forth, so on. Qala na'am. Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, fine, make condition. Qalat kayfa aqul, she said, how, what must I say? I mean, I don't know the words. Qal Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, quli, say labbaik allahumma labbaik. So we read the two rakat salat, and the salat is nafil, is voluntary. You read it, fine. You don't read it, also is fine. You make your intention for umrah or hajj, whatever the case is. So yeah, is hajj, and then labbaik allahumma labbaik. And then say, what a halili min al ardi haythu husihu bisti. And say, you will become a halal wherever you are, you know, prevented from going further due to illness or whatever else it might be. So it shows that a person can make this condition, and this is permissible according to the Shafi'is, Hanbalis, and them. Hanafis say that no, it is not permissible. So yeah, we find that, you know, there is a hadith to this effect, and the hadith of Duba'a, and that is what majority of the scholars use nowadays. But Hanafis say no, it is not permissible. They use the incident of Hudaybiyah in the 60 of the Hijrah. So what is the benefit of making this in this condition? Allah forbid, if a war breaks out, or the person falls ill, or some problems, you come out of ihram and you don't have to slaughter a goat or a sheep or anything of that sort. So that will be the benefit of it. Similarly, that she, Duba'a radiallahu anha, she saw Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam eating meat, thumma qama ila salat, and then Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam went and performed salat, walam yatawadda, and Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did not perform, you know, a wudu or an ablution. So this is ma masatin nar. You know, the masla is, if those things that touch the fire, so after eating, consuming that, must you make wudu and ablution. That was the law initially, but now that is no more the law, and we eat meat, chicken, all that, obviously touch the fire, so in that way your wudu will not break, your wudu will still be valid. So this is how these honorable Sahaba and Sahabiya, that they reported directly from Mustafa Habibuna sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and we find that senior Sahaba used to report from her, Abdullah bin Abbas, Hazrat Ayy, her daughter, that is that Duba'a radiallahu anha's daughter Karima. So we find that these were the great, great people of hadith. May Almighty Allah Jalla wa'ala grant us love for all of them. Barakallahu feek. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.